Let's steal your money. Let's go. Welcome, guys. My name's Robert Kate. Today we're getting sued today. Yes, we're getting sued. I love when I get sued. We're playing Squadrons, Star Wars Squadrons. After Adrian has destroyed plots for galaxy freedom. You know what? I had a character for Star Wars, a good character, an actual character that you probably sympathize with. So basically, it's a character, right? He's a Jedi. He's like an alien, or whatever, like, you know, non-human. He lived. Where, like, you know, like in number 5 or New Hope, Star Wars New Hope, where Naboo got destroyed. Well, I got an idea. What if one of the people of Naboo got off the planet just to before Darth Vader destroyed the planet? So I was kind of thinking a character that survived the Naboo destruction, and he's a Jedi. He has like a mixture of every single lightsaber. The reason why for that is because he hates both the Imperials and the Rebellion. Because the reason why he hates both of them. Sure, the Imperial destroyed the planet, but he figures out later on in his life, he'll figure out that Princess Leia, the Rebellion, actually told that Naboo, you know, the places in Naboo, like the hideout is on Naboo, and it's her fault as well. And so he tries to end the feud. He tries to, like, end, or she, I don't care. I actually don't care what gender it is, to be honest. Attacking both sides. Both sides of the equation. Because, you see, the rebellions, sure, they look for hope and freedom, yet that leads to destruction of other planets. So, like, without the rebellions, the Imperials won't attack. So it's basically like yin and yang. Rebellions are yin, Imperials are yang. Whenever the rebels go to these planets, the Imperials will find them and destroy that planet. And destroy all the civilizations, families, everything. And that's what that character is. Basically, he fights for the people. He fights for everyone. He fights for what, you know, everyone feels like. I just feel like that'd be a good character arc, to be honest. I don't fucking care what color. I don't care if it's a fucking man or woman, to be honest. Actually, we don't care, shit. What's the fucking difference? Body A, body type. It doesn't matter. Like, they're fucking both same, but one has goddamn. Is thin and one is kind of fat, so it doesn't really matter. Our victory is inevitable, of course. Yeah, I want that. Let's go. I want a person. I want a femboy. Thank you. Yeah. Try not to get in my way. That sounds British. It doesn't suit me. This won't take long. I go for British. You know what I mean? It sounds like these voices do not match any person. I don't fucking care about the name. You know what, I'll go for. How about this? Yeah, that's grand. Let's go. Oh, I can customize both of them.
They won't let us down. Standing
by. Happy to see me?
This ought to be fun.
Someone's got it.
I've never been more ready.
Okay, let's go. Okay, that I took so long just at the menu, then the actual game. Let's go. A long time ago. Oh no, I'm gonna get sued. 3, 2, 1, getting sued today. Let's go. Oh, it's not good. Oh, phew. Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you very much. My I swen that the opening theme song for
the survivors continue to spread dissent. Find them. Do not rest until the destruction of Alderaan is complete.
Alderaan.
Orders are clear.
Are they?
Yes. Wipe out all that remains.
Rebel Death Imperial.
Yeah, that's my name. Oh, that's funny. Oh, that's funny. It has like the name. It has the name and fucking in subtitles as well. That's funny. Really? First person?
Understood.
It sounds like a German guy now. Understood. Sorry if I systems up and running. We drive now?
Let's get a clean launch.
Go.
Go.
Jesus Christ.
Online and tracking.
Now, we go.
Throttle up and deploy out of the hangar.
Ah, rest of the fleet is back from Malastare. We'll have plenty of help to deal with that convoy of sympathizers. Helix Squadron, we're prepping your Gazanti transport. Stand by.
Copy vigilance. All pilots follow me. We'll do a quick pass of the fleet and calibrate flight controls.
No problem.
Stay mobile. We don't want any collisions.
From inside, you forget how big our star destroyers really are.
Careful. The shields won't harm us. Flying so close to the hull is no time to get careless.
You're right, sir. It is good to fly old school again. There's something very forthright about a TIE fighter.
Looks like someone's...
I'm not aware of my own size, to be honest.
Better here than in the field again.
Man, he goes very slow, doesn't he?
Keep your distance, Helix. Those engines run hot enough to vaporize a TIE.
Daredevils who found that out the hard way.
TIE pilots push the limits. Sometimes the limits push back.
Boring.
All systems calibrated, and the fleet is in good shape.
The Vigilance reports our Gazanti transport is ready.
Helix Squadron, head to the Gazanti and dock for hyperspace jump.
Not a problem.
Now you just... Scratch.
Follow down below the Gazanti so its locks can engage. Helix Squadron and dock and clear for hyperspace jump. Remember, Helix, we'll have support. Finding the refugee convoy is up to us.
They won't escape the Empire twice.
Very boring that was. Skip.
Inspecting those ships and see if the refugees are here.
I wish I was whole, not tap.
We're loyal, I swear.
Not part of the convoy. Check another ship. coordinates from Alderaan. Keep looking.
So you're not impounding my ship?
There. A ship's trying to flee from a simple inspection. We should teach them some manners.
All pilots, bring your weapon systems online. Pilot, track it on your sensors and fire a small volley. Just enough to damage them. Let's see if they're hiding their energies. There, stop that ship.
All right, scan us then. Stop shooting. No refugees here, sir. Just smuggled weapons and a cargo of spice.
Let the fleet handle those smugglers. We should get to the station. My customers are legitimate traitors. You have no right.
Captain, the station's defenses just activated.
Helix Squadron, destroy those turrets. We can't search under fire. Out here, no one shoots unless they're prepared for return fire. Even the Empire should know that.
Thank you.
Oops. I was just going around the whole place. That wasn't even. Everywhere, like, you can't even see them. They're like little flies, like, you can't. You can't even see them! Where are they? You can't see anything! All I see is just nothing. You know what the problem is with this? The charging. Lasers aren't doing darn.
Rebels.
I may have left. Where are you? Where are you? I got a shot. Got him a few times. I'm gonna heal and rave past him. There we go. Fuck off.
Pilot, see if you can bypass his shutdown.
Smash any button.
Catch up with that traitor. Lieutenant Carroll to the Vigilance. Captain James is aiding.
We're literally shooting directly at you. How is his engines not dead? I literally shot him like so many times. And now I am the rebellion, great. Is there the VR, is there the, what's it called? Not the VR, I'm talking about, you know, in New Hope, where, you know, Luke has to aim the shot, the charge shot. Is that in the, this game? I wouldn't say so, because this is this game.
Starting systems check.
Copy.
Power management. Like, this one explains it more thoroughly, should I say. It explains it more easy. Shield power. Oh!
Right. We might need to hold out a while.
I see. That's pretty easy to understand. So, basically, let's put it like this way. Left stick is speed and mobility. So that basically means you gain more speed. The other one is rechargeability. Basically meaning that your things will recharge faster. And the right one is your protection. Okay. So this one right here will recharge my stuff. This one here will defend me. And this one here will just make more speed, to be honest.
Echo 3, matching formation.
Echo 2,
where am I going? What the fuck?
Echo 5, standing by.
I literally just passed him. I literally just passed this guy. What, missiles? What the fuck? How come the Rebellion has missiles and the Imperials don't have missiles? That's bullshit. Fuck. What the fuck? Did the R2-D2 just run in? Yeah, let's go. Wait, how do you shoot the, oh, that's how. Reach for coordinates. Looks like defibrillators. Oh, look, Doctor Who.
Way over there, but the bad guy's between us and them.
Echo Squadron, transfer all power to engines. Head below the Star Destroyer and wait for my signal. It's risky, but flying fast and close to the Star Destroyer's hull should get us to the other side safely. Steady. Hold. Now, fire all boost thrusters. Echo 5, wait, you two. Damn it, 5. Squadron, focus. We are not losing anyone else.
Get formation. Capital ships are moving in. Rebel Alliance forces. The convoy needs support.
Wait, that was an Imperial transmission on an open channel.
Echo Squadron, move in and give them cover.
I'm glad someone heard my distress call. I couldn't hold off those ties any longer.
Who are you? A defector?
If you'll take me. Call me Lynn. I'll explain later. Pilot, help me push these fighters back.
Echo 4, leave that quasar for now. Focus on ties. Then we better get rid of those ties. Fire missiles!
Oh, this is easy! This is so easy! Jesus Christ, why is the Imperial so hard? Right, shut up.
You're on my tail? Good looking out.
Enemy down. Oh, you just...
You stressed your lasers. On fire while they recharge.
Following your lead.
Defend the convoy before it's too late.
What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? My brain's gone. Sorry. I'm trying my best, man. This whole thing is like just bubbling. I'm trying not to die, and I'm trying not to. Die. This is bad. The things don't lock on so fast. I literally spin around and they do. Not again, not with the f***ing ties again. Time for discombobulation simulator 2002. There is VR for this, but there is. I'll try it out. If it's not good, it's not good. If it is good, it is good. It's not that bad. But I expected more, to be honest, from fucking... I expected nothing from fucking, Come on. Literally, it's either A, I miss, or B. They're literally like gone.
Trying to get cover.
Where is he? Where is he? Jesus Christ! You're so slow!
Refugee convoy to Rebel Alliance. We're ready for light speed, Joe. Wait. The Star Destroyer will be watching all possible vectors. They can still find you. Pilot,
my hands are sweaty. Neat, sweet arms are heavy. There's bomb enough. Star Destroyers! No! Those are bad. They get deep bloody figures because they are the like... I'm trying my best, man. Like, literally... No! Damn! All I had to do is rush. What? whatever. Okay. It's okay. I wouldn't say it's the best game that EA has done, but it's certainly not the worst. It's okay. Like, I give that like a meh. I say if I had to give this game a rating out of 10, I'll probably give this... it's okay. But generally the problem is... It's really not really immersive. All you're doing is just spinning around and doing nothing, and you're basically trying to find one single like TIE fighter or like anything or any aircraft. That's why I hated Star Wars Battlefronts, goddamn. Well, I kind of do. I like Star Wars Battlefronts way of, you know, the flyer jets, because, you know, they're easy to use, they're easy to control. This one, on the other hand, is in first person, so it makes it extra hard. And with that, I give that a 6, because motion control is this control isn't really good. Like, you're going the whole, like, I was like spinning around for at least a minute. I was just spinning around trying to find one single thing. I cut off all the power to see where this one single person was. And that's bad. Because you're supposed to follow these people, things around. Like, yes, a Star Destroyer is easier to see than a goddamn TIE fighter. So yeah, that's it. It's okay. I wouldn't give it that much credit. Like, I would still rather Star Wars Battlefront. But it's okay.